The right of the citizens
of the United States
shall not be denied or abridged by the United States
or by any state
on account of sex.
Congress shall have power to enforce this article
by appropriate legislation.
When I think about the legacy of voting rights in this country, I am reminded of the darker times in our country's history.
Many women were thrown in jail, told they were crazy to think that we should have this right, that they were unfeminine to want this right. Many were cast out of their families, yet they prevailed, they fought, and it is both infuriating and heartbreaking and inspiring to learn what they went through just to get us to this point today.
I can't imagine how powerless women felt. How marginalized, how unfairly it felt to be treated this way.
We don't just have a right to vote, we have a duty to vote.
I can't help but think back to my very first time voting at Indiana University in Bloomington, and I remember walking out of the voting facility and feeling so empowered and wearing that I voted sticker with such pride, knowing that my voice counted.
When I think of the legacy of voting rights for women, it makes me feel powerful and that little old me can actually make a difference like the women who came before me.
As a woman, the right to vote means having power. Having power to participate in the process, having power to influence the society in which I live, in which I work, in which I'm raising my children, in which I am a daughter.
There was a victory for women 100 years ago, but it was only the beginning of a much longer battle.
100 years ago, women won the right to vote, but that victory was not passed on to all women. Women of color were not given the same rights at the same time.
Black women, women who looked like me, were not given those same rights. It really benefited mostly wealthier white women. And so it is to be celebrated because yes, it was a moment of change in our country, but I do think that we need to remember how much more change needed to happen even at that time.
These laws did not end patriarchy. The law did not end racism. Those societal and systematic issues are still with us. And so as celebratory as we can be, I think it's a charge to make it even better in the future.
The 19th Amendment, it's a reminder of how far we've come, but also a reminder that we have to keep fighting for what we want.
We still have a long ways to go in things like pay inequality and things like equal representation in politics and things like gender inequality in household chores and childcare.
Women are half the population. It's unthinkable to ponder this concept of women not having civic responsibility and also civic rights.
This is an election year, and everyone has the opportunity to make their voice heard and an obligation, a civic duty, to do just that.
We need to know our history. And so as we celebrate the 100th anniversary of the 19th Amendment, we need to remember who was left out at that time so that we can make sure as we continue fighting for equal rights heading into the future that that's never again the case.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.